Hello everyone, welcome to the 8th lecture of heat transfer. This lecture is about thermal and electrical resistance analogy. In lecture 7 we have already discussed about the temperature distribution through plane wall. In this lecture we will discuss the thermal and electrical resistance analogy. As we know that in electrical resistance, when two electrical resistors are connected in series, then the total resistance of the resistor will be equal to, suppose this is the two resistor, these are suppose connected in series, this is a voltage and this is the current flow through the resistor. This is resistor 1 and this is resistor 2. Now the total resistor with these two resistors are connected in series. Now the total resistance is equal to resistance 1 plus resistance of the resistor 2. So the overall resistance in this case is the sum of the resistances. Now if two resistors are connected in parallel, suppose the two resistors which are connected in parallel. Suppose the two resistor, this is the voltage, and so in this case the overall resistance is equal to reciprocal of resistances. So this is the concept of resistance in heat transfer. In heat transfer this is the resistance concept in electrical engineering. In heat transfer, the concept of resistance is similar to the electrical resistances. So there is a relation between thermal resistance and electrical resistances. Now, suppose this is a plane wall and there is some hot fluid. Suppose there is the one side. Suppose this is the hot fluid, it is at temperature T1, and this is the surface temperature which is TS1, and this is the another surface temperature TS2, and the heat flow from the hot heat flow through the wall in this direction. This is the length of the wall. Suppose this is the length of the wall and there is a cold fluid at temperature suppose this is the temperature T infinity 1 and the cold fluid is T infinity 2 and this is the surface is TS1 and this surface is TS2. Now there are three resistances to the heat transfer. First of all, the heat will transfer to the heat will flow through the heat will flow through the fluid. The heat will flow through the fluid in this direction. Then the heat will flow through the wall by conduction. The heat will flow through the fluid in convection. Then it will transfer through the wall and through conduction. Then after it will transfer through the fluid again in convection heat transfer. So there are three resistances to the heat flow. One is convective resistance, the other is resistance through conduction, and the third one is resistance through convection. And the overall resistance in this case, which is the total resistance, is equal to resistance through convection plus resistance through conduction plus resistance through convection. So the overall resistance is the resistance of convection heat transfer, resistance to convection heat transfer, resistance to conduction heat transfer, resistance to convection heat transfer. Now we know that from Ohm law is we know that current is directly proportional to voltage. We can also write V is equal to IR and R is equal to V by I. So we can write resistance is equal to voltage difference, potential difference divided by current. From this we can write the general definition of resistance. which show that resistance is gradient divided by flow of quantity due to this gradient. Suppose electrical resistance is equal to gradient, which is voltage, potential difference, and the flow of quantity, suppose the flow of current, which is due to this potential difference. So the gradient divided by the flow of quantity, some quantity which may be current or heat, which due to this gradient. So this is the general definition of resistance. So now we will apply this definition of resistance to the heat transfer. Suppose let us consider the, as we know that the Fourier law of heat conduction is Qx, in the x direction is Qx is equal to Ka dT by dx. So now we can rearrange this equation dT by dx divided by K, which is Qxo. And as we know that resistance is equal to gradient divided by flow of some quantity. So resistance is equal to gradient divided by flow of some quantity of quantity. So we can, so this, suppose this is equation A. Now rearrange this equation A, we will get dx divided by Ka is equal to dT by Qxo. This is the gradient, this is temperature gradient T2 minus T1, and this is the flow of heat. Gradient divided by flow of something, so gradient, temperature gradient, and the flow of heat. So the flow of heat which is due to this temperature gradient is equal to dx by Ka, and this is known as resistance to conduction heat transfer. So resistance to conduction heat transfer, which can be resistance to conduction heat transfer, is equal to dx by Ka. Suppose dx is equal to length of the wall Ka. So resistance to conduction heat transfer is due to length of the wall. So similarly for convection heat transfer, as you know that from Coulomb law, which is equal to H A T infinity 1 minus T S 1. Suppose this is the heat transfer coefficient. Suppose this is the heat transfer coefficient in at this side of the plane wall, and the heat transfer coefficient at this side of the plane wall is H2. So the heat transfer from this fluid to this side is by convection heat transfer, which is H1 into area T infinity minus surface temperature. And similarly the heat transfer from this side to this fluid is also by convection, which is Q is equal to H2 into area through which the heat transfer by convection occur, and TS2 minus T infinity 2, and this is, and the heat transfer through the wall is by conduction, which is Ka dT by dxo, and dx is in this case is length of the wall. So from Newton law of cooling, which is Q is equal to Ha T infinity 1 minus TS1o, so rearrange this equation, we will get Q divided by H1a is equal to T infinity 1 minus TS1. So we can rearrange this equation T infinity 1 minus TS1 divided by heat transfer rate, which is equal to 1 over H1a. So again this is the gradient divided by flow of something, which is called resistance, and it is called convective resistance. Resistance to convection heat transfer, convection resistance. So resistance to convection heat transfer. Similarly, the heat flow, Similarly, when the heat flow from this side of the wall to the flute, there will also again convection heat resistance, and it can be obtained from Newton's law of cooling, which is Q is equal to H2A heat transfer coefficient at the other side of the wall, and TS2 minus T infinity 2. So rearrange this equation, we will get 1 over H2A is equal to TS2 minus T infinity 2 divided by heat transfer on the other side of the wall. So this is again temperature gradient divided by heat transfer due to convection, and it is called convective resistance, which is also convection resistance. So the overall resistance in this case, is due to convection resistance, conduction resistance, and convection resistance. So there are two convective resistance and one conductive resistance, and the overall resistance is equal to total resistance, which is resistance to convection on one side of the wall, resistance to conduction plus resistance through convection through other side of the wall. Now putting the value, the overall resistance is equal to resistance to conduction, which is given. This is resistance to conduction, L by Ka. So putting the value, this is resistance to conduction, putting the value of L by Ka, and resistance to convection at one side of the wall, which is given to us, which is 1 over H1 and 2A. So 1 over H1 and 2A plus resistance to conduction, as we have already obtained. So plus the convective resistance to other side of the wall, which is given to us. This is the convective resistance at the other side of the wall, TS2 minus T infinity 2 divided by Q. So 1 over H2A. So the overall resistance is due to convection heat transfer, conduction heat transfer, and convection heat transfer again. Now if there is some radiation source, then resistance to radiation heat transfer will also consider. As we know that Q is equal to heat transfer coefficient due to radiation heat transfer into area, temperature of the surface minus temperature of the surrounding. So from this relation we can also say that Q divided by heat transfer coefficient due to radiation heat transfer multiplied by area is equal to TS minus T temperature of the surrounding divided by HR divided into A is equal to TS of the surround. Now rearrange this equation, we will get temperature of the surface minus temperature of the surrounding divided by Q is equal to 1 over HR into A. So this is the radiation heat resistance to the radiation heat transfer. Now if we are interested to include the radiation term, then the overall resistance will become total resistance will become resistance to convection plus resistance to conduction plus resistance to convection plus resistance to radiation. And if we putting the value of these resistances, which is 1A plus L by Ka, which is given to us, this is the resistance to L by Ka conduction. So this is the resistance to conduction, and this is the resistance to convection at other side of the wall, and this is the resistance through radiation, this is resistance to the radiation heat transfer. So the overall resistance is due to convection plus conduction plus convection again plus radiation heat transfer. So the overall resistance is equal to resistance of convection, resistance to, so the overall resistance to the heat transfer is equal to the resistance to heat transfer due to convection, conductance resistance, convective resistance, and radiation to the heat transfer resistance due to radiation heat transfer. Thanks. If you are new to my channel, please like and subscribe.